Hi, my name's Andy, and I'm an instructor at Udacity. I worked with Sarah and Ian and Gundega to help prepare this lesson, and today I'm going to deliver it for you. So let's get started. Up to this point, you've familiarized yourself with MapReduce. You've written some mapper code, some reducer code, and you probably have a decent understanding of what's going on behind the scenes. But you might not yet know when to use MapReduce to solve a problem. And that's what we're gonna try and get at in this lesson. We're gonna give you a bunch of problems to solve. And actually, each of these problems has been deliberately selected because each of these problems actually represents some larger class of problems. In reality, the problems you're likely to run into on the job are going to fall into one of these certain classes of problems, which is very convenient because it means you can apply a sort of boilerplate solution with some modification. These boilerplate solutions we call design patterns, and they're really helpful. In this lesson, we'll learn about some of these design patterns, and we'll practice using them on various problems. We're not going to get into the details of where the patterns came from or why they look the way they do. But at the very least, at the end of this lesson, you will have, well, for one, you have practice using these patterns, and you'll also have a resource that you can always come back to whenever you run into a problem that can be solved using one of these patterns. If this kind of stuff is really interesting to you, you should definitely check out a book called MapReduce Design Patterns. It's written by Donald Miner and Adam Shook, and it's really interesting. Anyways, let's get started.